Why does our state have to always be associated with violent crime?
I mean, that's the way it is here, man.
Yeah. Okay, so we just watched Clove Hitch Killer on Amazon. Really, really short kind of explanation of our thoughts. Really fucking good.
Yeah, I liked it a lot, for sure.
Yeah, it's really good. But to kind of get a bit more in-depth with it, if you love David Fincher, you know, shows like Mindhunter or Gone Girl, stuff like that, where there's just this kind of like cold preciseness to it, you're probably going to love this. It's really fucking good.
Yeah. Especially if you like things that kind of also focus a little bit on, I guess the everyday life of a killer, I guess you could say.
Yeah. Yeah. Or just kind of the process and the mentality of a killer, or the exploration of people around that killer in their everyday life. But to kind of bring it all back so we don't get ahead of ourselves, Clove Hitch Killer is a movie from 2018 that was really independent, just this kind of low budget thing made by, you know, some guy. I'm sure if you watch the Red Letter Media video about this, because they actually did end up talking about it, they go a bit more in depth with how this guy had experience with making just some online stuff for a YouTube channel and all that. But this guy came out swinging. This is his first like feature movie, and the basic rundown is this kid growing up in Kentucky, you know, the state we live in, sadly enough, which is now only known for Justified, which is a show about cops going after racist drug dealing gangs, and now Clove Hitch Killer, which is about a psychopathic murderer.
What more do we have to offer than violence?
Yeah. But anyway, this kid growing up in like small town church community Kentucky begins to suspect his dad may or may not be a notorious serial killer by the name of the Clove Hitch Killer. And it's just kind of exploring that whole aspect of him trying to figure out what's going on while balancing out not letting his family fall apart.
Yeah, can't let his family find out. And he's also trying to balance like his social standing in this really tight-knit community where any slip up at all can pretty much have you branded for your entire life.
You are beaten over the head with it constantly, yeah. And
whether you're guilty or not.
Yeah, and the movie is really good, but I will say that beginning can be a little rough if you really roll your eyes at like really over the top representations of, I guess, like religious people.
Yeah, because we live here, and even like I don't know about you, since this is your second time watching it, but I was like, oh my God, please stop, please God.
Yeah, it's only in the beginning, because really shortly after the whole killer thing even gets explored, a lot of that stuff completely vanishes.
It just gets thrown out the window.
Yeah.
Not in a bad way or anything.
No, because priorities are set.
Yeah, but it definitely has a slow burning start to it, that's for sure.
Yeah, because a lot of it is, in a lot of ways, a story about the main kid, the son of his, you know, the Clove Hitch Killer. And basically just about him trying to figure out the truth of what's going on. Is his dad actually a killer? Like, what's the explanation behind everything? And it does play with the whole idea of the community is kind of brainwashing itself not to believe this, just because the guy that plays the dad, I want to say his name was Dylan McDormand.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I want to say that was it. Someone's going to correct me if I'm wrong. And, you know, thanks, guys, for calling me a retard.
But, as it should be.
Yeah, but basically, the guy who plays the dad is extremely good at playing a dad.
Yeah.
That sounds super weird, but he has almost everything down. The really cheesy humor, just the schlub that shops at Kroger look, you know, that kind of like camo shorts and goatee look.
So, yeah, a little overweight. He doesn't look like a fitness model or anything by any means.
No, he is just a dude, and the way he's performed is just so pinpoint to how someone we see every day on the street acts. And that makes the whole aspect of the movie where you start exploring the killer and kind of that whole aspect really creepy and terrifying, and just how easy someone can mask some really fucked up shit.
Yeah, how easy anyone can just slip into your ranks and you have no idea about it.
Yeah, and I don't really want to say too much about spoilers, because this is a movie that really revolves around the mystery. It's a literal mystery movie.
Yeah.
You know, that's the whole point. It's a thriller. But it is one of those where it can get pretty fucking disturbing pretty quickly, because they do explore some fucked up sexual stuff, like, you know, bondage kinks and BDSM and stuff like that. And it's never anything really gratuitous. Like, in terms of serial killers, if you were ever going to get murdered by one, I would actually want to be killed by Clovitch. Simply because, like...
I'm not going to be beheaded, and my beheaded head is not going to get fucked.
Yeah, it's not like an Edmund Kemper thing where you will die and die horribly.
Yeah.
I mean, you'll still die pretty bad from Clovitch, but unless they implied some rapey stuff that I just missed, which is my second time watching it, so I don't know if I could have missed it, but really, it just seems like, yeah, he strangles you to death. So it's not really about watching these really fucked up, gratuitous kills, like something like Seven.
Yeah.
Where Seven was really emphasizing that if this guy got his hands on you, you were, like, barely recognizable by the time they found your body. No, it's not about the kills, it's about the mentality of the killer and the psychology of the killer, and just exploring how someone that can look so safe and milquetoast. I think you outright called him Ned Flanders at one point as a joke.
Yeah, I was like, this movie would be a million times better if they just had Ned Flanders as the main character.
Yeah, and basically...
It basically became that.
Yeah, it basically became that, and then you find out, like, holy shit, this dude's like two steps away from becoming fucking Leatherface.
Yeah.
It's like, Jesus, man, this dude is messed up in the head. But that's the appeal of this movie. I mean, it's not a Jason Statham fighting a giant shark popcorn style thing. This is something that you watch because you're interested in serial killers and in kind of true crime type shit, which, you know, I know for a fact I am. Like, are you actually interested in any of that shit? Or
yeah, I definitely really really like that. I guess I don't know if you can call it a genre or not, but yeah, that sort of stuff I'm definitely interested in.
Yeah, and that definitely helps a lot with the fact that there is that grim fascination, because really, what other reason would you have to watch a woman crying as a man, like, ties her up and starts to strangle her to death? Like, why else would you watch that other than, man, it's a cool serial killer thing? You watch that because you thought it was funny. That says a lot about you, motherfucker.
I swear we have more to offer than just violence.
Yeah. It's like, no, it's not just violence. We have context behind the violence that makes it even worse. So, I think pretty much all the performances were pretty all right. The main kid, I think he did really good in some scenes.
Yeah, some other scenes, though, he felt like borderline, like, just under okay. But yeah. I don't know if it's because of him or if it's because of the people that were around him. Because some of this stuff just... People don't really feel like they act like people, you know?
Sometimes. And that could just be a stylistic thing where it's supposed to feel very cold and alien, like a David Fincher thing.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's like... There are some scenes, like, there's a scene where he meets the, kind of the girl of the movie. That's all I'm really going to say about her. But
The girl, TM.
Yeah, the girl, TM, of the movie. And they're talking by riverbank, and the girl, I think, did pretty good.
Yeah.
She does really good. But him, there's a few lines where it feels like he's stumbling around, doesn't really know what to say.
He has a very detached feel to it, to his delivery on some lines. Almost serial killer-esque, you know?
Which could be an intentional thing, yeah. Because of some things that happen in the movie.
Yeah, which is like a, you know, I don't know whether you intended it to be delivered this way or not.
Yeah. So there, like I said, there are just some head-scratchers. Nothing that will really pull you out as, like, horrible porno-level acting. Nothing like that.
No,
nothing like that. And really, a lot of the movie is just carried by Dylan McDormand's performance, the dad. He just steals every single scene he's in. Like I said, he has that energy that he knows exactly what to do in every fucking scene. Yeah. And it really carries the movie.
Definitely has a commanding appearance for like a middle-aged dad.
Yeah, just his absolute presence is like, it's hard to ignore him, and it's almost impossible to. And it's really good that the movie revolves a lot around his character, because it does touch on the other members of the family, but it's never excessive.
Yeah.
Where you have to know about the mom's day-to-day routine or the little sister's day-to-day routine. That's not really the point.
Yeah,
it's more about the son and the dad, their relationship, and how this mystery is kind of eroding everything they thought they knew of each other. So, I personally really liked it.
Yeah, I really liked it as well. I'd definitely recommend it.
Yeah, it's extremely fucked up, but in that good way.
In the way you want it to be fucked up. It's not gore porn, I swear.
Yeah, it's not gore porn. I will bring it back once again to, like, if you like David Fincher stuff, especially stuff like Mindhunters, where it's this really cold, just no bullshit exploration of a serial killer's mind, then you're probably going to love this. A lot of the reason I even picked this movie is because I liked Mindhunters quite a bit. That's one of my favorite shows on Netflix. You know, by the way, when the fuck is season two? But anyway, it's just, it's a perfect movie for people that already love the genre. So I say go watch it. You kind of have to rent it or buy it off Amazon. I don't think there's any way you can watch it for free right now.
Yeah, not as far as I know. At least not, like, legally, of course.
Yeah, not legally. It's not on Netflix. It's on Amazon. I say it's worth the money. You can rent it for, like, $4.
Yeah.
And I say it's completely worth it. I really enjoyed it. My friend here really enjoyed it. It's just, once again, one of those you kind of have to be in the mood for.
Yeah, this isn't a party movie, that's for sure.
Yeah, you don't watch this in front of grandma, unless grandma's also into fucked up serial killer stuff.
Which case, be safe.
Yeah. Alright, so see you guys.
See ya.